meet the Kinkajou. While it appears to be a devilish lively cross between a ferret and a monkey, the Kinkajou is actually from the same vicious nocturnal family tree as the raccoon. I, for one, have never heard of the Kinkajou before this week when an article appeared in the news about one of these feisty creatures causing trouble while rooting around on the rooftop of a family home in rural Texas. While the animal was eventually captured, it was only after it had bitten a deputy through a bite-proof protective glove. Once captured, the little bastard also escaped and terrorized a group of house cats and had to be recaptured. There is no word on whether anyone was bitten during the second capture. Well, apparently lots of other people have heard of this animal, and some have even raised them as pets. If you are at all familiar with my irrational fear of animals, nature, the sea, out of doors, circus clowns, certain types of wood, and children with two different colored eyes, you probably realize that this wily little biter is simply another one of God's creatures that will torment me in my dreams. It has claws and raccoon-like fingers, which have always seemed creepy to me, sharp little teeth, and quite a temper when riled. How is it that there are new animals, mostly vicious, that keep coming into the picture that I have never gotten wind of before this? Where in the hell have they been? I have a feeling that they've always been around and that they're being doled out one at a time to keep us on our toes. I read about new types of bear, monkey, rodent, spider, sea creature, Sasquatch, and deadly new varieties of fire ant and honeybees that can decimate entire civilizations. Perfect. I have given everyone fair warning that we need to start thinking about defending ourselves against these creatures. And I don't mean simply capturing one or two and tossing them into a cage at a zoo or loosing them in a wildlife preserve. I say that if they're not needed to provide me with prime rib, chicken tenders, or pork chops, get rid of them altogether. Do you really think that there's a purpose for the Kinkajou other than to bedevil me in my dreams? I say feed the Kinkajou to the fire ants. Maybe if we can fill their little ant bellies with Kinkajou meat, they will become logy and easier to exterminate. Now, I understand that there are do-gooders out there who want to make certain that no species of life on the planet goes extinct, and I have a solution for them as well. Throw them to the Kinkajou and the honey badger. When they get their bellies full of do-gooder, perhaps they too will become logy and the fire ants will be on them that much quicker. Circle of life, you know, only to my own comforting end. Away with the badger and the sloth, the Kinkajou, its raccoon cousin, rats, the smaller mice rats, bears. Unless they're tasty, I've never eaten bear. Spiders of all ilk, especially those that fly. Snakes, armadillos, and hedgehogs. And I know they're teeny and seem harmless, but let's get rid of the mole. They're creepy eyeless and hairless. F*** them. The big cats and wild dogs while we're at it. They're mean and carnivorous and need to have the African honeybees set upon them. Basically, what I'm proposing is a world populated by people, us, their domesticated pets, reptiles excluded, them too, and friendly, docile animals that are tasty when served with potatoes or a green vegetable of choice. If ranch dressing or ketchup is needed to make the animal palatable, then we need to consider setting the fire ants to them. Once we have suitably dealt with these beasts, vermin, varmints, and pests, we can get to work on the circus clowns. We just need to be sure we have some fire ants and honeybees left. It pays to be judicious when cleaning up a planet.